Time for the PlayStation. Enjoy my channel and have fun.
Hi and welcome to my retro gaming zone. I'm Tomaniac and again I'm playing a game on the PlayStation 1. And this time I take a look at Burning Road. This is the only game, PS1 game, I got from the last retro gaming fair at Nordweikerhout with my mate Shadow's Nose. And yeah, I collected for many other systems and this oh, everything falls apart. So you can see this is not in the best condition, but the game itself seems to work. So and this is the cockpit perspective, so demo mode, and you can see something there already. It looks interesting, so to say, and let's press start and see how it plays. Start is pressed. Now loading Burning Road. And I load also something. I load some white wine. This time it comes from Spain. Never tried out a Spanish white wine, but it loses my tongue, and my English seems to get better with every sip I take. Link mode. Does this mean you can connect two or more PlayStations together? I don't know. Let's take a short look at the options. This is the first time I play this game. Accelerate, rectangle and brake. So you only need to accelerate and to brake. Can you alter these controls? Brake and accelerate this. Okay. These are the two options. Oh no. So accelerate this one. Okay, and brake this one. Yeah, this is what I would prefer. FX volume, CD volume, overall volume, more. So what's more to adjust? Analog setup. Aha. So moment. Now I've turned my controller to analog mode, but nothing happens. I can't control anything when it's turned to analog, then everything is frozen. So I have to turn this off. What the fuck? And then it works, so you only can use the D-pad. So why is this analog setup? Don't know. Exit. Practice? Ah, who needs practice? Let's go to the championship mode and get screwed up.
Select a car.
What can I choose? Oh, acceleration, max speed, road holding. Road holding. I think road holding is not the best, not the worst solution. Let's take this one. Wasn't this the first car? Ah, AT means automatic translation. This means automatic gear shifting. Yeah, whenever I can choose between automatic and manual, then I choose automatic because I hate manual gear shifting in a computer game. So acceleration was this was the circle and brake was the triangle. Can I choose the camera position? And if so, how? Not with this. Okay. Yes, with the L1 I can choose positions farther away from the car, so the camera's more behind the car. And with the L2 I can get closer. Yes, okay. And then I see something is wiggling at my front window. What is this? Tow car? Touring cars challenge? Or what does this mean? And then we have the front spoiler cam and... And what else can we choose? Nothing else. Nothing else matters. Let's take a look through the cockpit window. Juhu! Time extension! Und who uses the brake is a loser! So only guess is the only solution. Or is it? Okay, let's choose a camera angle more away from the car. This time. Yeah, I would prefer this. So I can see a bit more of the course. Oh, this is dark here, this part. Hardly can see something. Wow! And sometimes it's hard to control the car. Especially in sharp curves. Traffic. What does this radar mean? What does it say? Because I don't see anything in the radar. Except myself. Ah, now the others. And would be so cool if I can overtake some of them, but I don't think so. Just the smallest mistake is a mistake too much. You have placed 8th. I guess this is not a good place. 8th of 8. Awesome! Replay. Okay. So, these are the camera angles when replay is shown and the wheels are not round. Okay, so this might be the reason that I didn't make it to a place near the top. Okay, so let's zip another wine. Oh, I can fly, as I've seen there. And let's do this again, and perhaps we can change to another course. Position, last. Time to continue, time, total goal bonus, position bonus, time bonus, damage bonus, total score, push, start to continue, I do so. You are not qualified for the next race, sorry. Don't drink and drive, that's the matter. Top 10, I'm not in it. Why should I? I haven't earned this. So, championship. Another try. Let's choose another car and fail with that one. What about failing with this one? Let's fail with this car. 80 again. Graphically, yeah, I've seen worse, so to say. But what do you think about this racing game for the PS1? Please write it down into the comments. I really appreciate reading your comments. I love reading your comments. I love interaction with you. So please write. Right now. Right now. Right now. Okay. Yes, I'm drunk a little bit. But who cares? It's weekend. I can drink as much as I like to. I don't give a fuck about it. There's no police officers to control me right now. When I'm steering this. Ah, I thought I could kick this one out of my way. At the moment I'm not on the last position, but I think in the end I will be last. Why should I make a good place? It's really not easy to keep in on the street. To keep up with the opponents. Ooh-ah. Okay, sometimes it may be helpful to brake. What I have done so right now. My finger is on the gas trigger. And the only thing I do is release my finger from the gas button in the bends, in the curves, and then press the button again. But yeah, hardly use the brake button. But yeah, and somehow I can fly this. Or let me pass. Time extension! Okay. What are these barrels for? What do they do? Why do they lie there on the street? In the middle of the road. And as far as I know, I don't have any extra weapons. I thought this is a fair racing game. But as many of the PS1 games, I think this also is difficult to master. You aren't allowed to make any slightest mistakes. Oh, what is with my wheel? My left wheel. I have some problems. It seems to be a bit damaged, and oh, this was close! I hardly made it through the time gate. And yeah, I think I'm a bit damaged. You've placed 8th. Again! 8th from 8! Fuck. Okay, no chance. Meh. Does it support 2-player mode? Let's take a short look. One or two players, and hopefully you can play two players simultaneously. Link cable for two consoles. Ah, as I thought about, you indeed can link two PS1 consoles with each other. And then, do you also need to have two monitors? Think so. So like Daytona USA, where you can link more consoles together if you have enough monitors, like in some arcades. It seems you can do a similar thing here. Okay, well, again, I think if you have two human players, then this might be more fun to play. What I don't see here is if there's a split screen then. And I think sooner or later I have to get my son into retro gaming. He's 13 now, and at the moment I haven't shown him too many of my retro systems, but I think I should get him into it so that sooner or later I have an opponent I can compete with and we can try out these two-player modes. I hope he's interested. I don't know. Perhaps not. And then, yeah. Shall it be? Yes, what do you think about this game? I would like to read your comments down below into the comment section. And I hope you had fun watching this video as much as I have had fun trying this out. And I hope to see you next time, and stay tuned. Bye till then.